Darling, if you'll just open the door, I'm sure I could... Julie! Open this door!
Banging on a lady's door. I'm scandalized at you. Well, did you come up here just to stand there?
Julie, how long must we go on like this?
Like what, Preston?
Fighting, fussing all the time like a couple of children.
Why do you treat me like a child?
Because you act like one, a spoiled one.
You used to say you liked me like that once. You never wanted me to change. Remember?
What a press in a lady's bedroom. Now you'll have to marry me.
What do you figure I aim to do?
Then kiss me again.
See my new dress?
That's what I wanted to do all day.
Well, let me go then. There it is.
For the Olympus ball?
Isn't it lovely?
Julie, it's red.
It's gorgeously red.
You can't wear red to the Olympus ball.
Why not?
You never saw an unmarried girl in anything but white.
Well, you're going to see one tomorrow night.
Julie, you can't be serious.
Are you afraid somebody will take me for one of those girls from Gallatin Street?
Julie!
I forgot I'm a child. I'm not supposed to know about things like Gallatin Street. I'm just supposed to flutter around in white.
You're supposed to know better than to scandalize the whole town.
It might be bad for the bank. Of course. Will you please hold another director's meeting and ask him to decide what I can wear?
Julie, for heaven's sake, will you be reasonable?
Were you reasonable this afternoon?
So that's it. You're just nursing a spite. Well, I'm not going to let you. You've made your point, for once you're going to do as I say. I'm calling for you tomorrow night at 10, and you're going to be dressed properly for the ball in white.
Am I? Oh, but of course, Preston, if you say so.
Don't be absurd. Your own good sense will say so.
And if it doesn't?
Then, my sweet, you and I will sit at home quietly with our embroidery. Good night. Tomorrow night at 10.
Oh, Preston, you forgot your stick.
So I did. I forgot to use it, too.
So you did.